Hey, sorry I'm late for dinner.
Oh, dinner! That's why I came in here.
I stopped by Dad's after work to check on him.
Yeah, how's he adjusting to life with the new pacemaker?
Well, he seemed fine, but I could tell they were hurrying me out. Especially when Dad said, hurry and get out.
Well, you think he's not feeling well and he's trying to hide it?
Something's going on. I need to get to the bottom of it.
When's dinner?
I have been down here working on it for hours. I am only one person.
Hey, Katie, can you go check on Grandpa? Snoop around, see how he's doing, and report back to me?
I don't like the idea of spying.
What? I'll give you $20.
Okay, I'll do anything for money.
Well, that's comforting to a father.
Grandpa? Everybody okay?
Bev, if you're gonna talk dirty, talk louder. You know I don't hear too good.
Hey, Katie, how was Grandpa?
I don't want to talk about it.
Well, wait, what did you find out?
That you might have a little brother coming soon.
I found Kate's purse at our place. I guess she left it there when, well, you know.
What? I don't know.
She caught your father and me in a compromising position. Or positions. I'm not sure how long she was standing there.
Ma, don't say positions to me. Poor Katie. No wonder she was asking to go to church.
Your father's new pacemaker has had some side effects. It's made him very randy.
Okay, thanks for stopping by.
I mean, he's like a new man. We haven't done some of that stuff since Nixon.
Seriously, you have to stop talking before this whole house turns to ash.
Wait, I need a favor. Ask your dad to turn down his pacemaker. A little, nothing dangerous. I just need time to run a few errands.
Why can't any of you keep your hands off each other?
Dad? Mom? This is as far as I'm coming in. Hello? I'm inside the house.
It's okay. You don't have to talk to Dad. I doubled up on my B12s. Everything's hunky-dory.
Run along, boy. This is grown-up time.